Is your IDE loading time slow? Should you even care? If you're using Neovim like me, and why wouldn't you, given it's been chosen yet again as the most admired editor in the Stack Overflow survey of 2023? Anyway, startup time is pretty easy to test. You can start Neovim with the startup time flag, preferably writing the output to a file, which we can then read and analyze. As you can see, almost 200 milliseconds in my case, and while it's not as bad as one would imagine, it's not something to be proud of. As Neovim users, we're already used to a world of difference when it comes to loading times and resource consumption of the IDE. Yes, Neovim is an IDE, check the video above if you have any doubts. But as time goes on, we discover more and more plugins. Not all of us are Puritans using Vim or vanilla power users doing everything without any plugins. TreeSitter, LSP, DAP for debugging, all of these are a fraction of the capabilities you can get with plugins installed. But they come with a little bit of a price, not always visible, but here it is. I've asked the channel audience how long it takes for users to load their Neovim sessions and found out I was very late to the game. While 200 milliseconds is not all that much, for a Neovim user I was disappointed, but I felt like it's a failure when I saw the answers. If you dig deeper, it's clear why. Not only plugins are improving, new plugin managers are taking over. From the wonderful hands of Folk, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, which is a growing name in the Neovim sphere, meet Lazy, a modern package manager, as its GitHub page says. It's not only fast, it's smart and it's beautiful.
You get a nice visual UI to handle plugins and packages. It renders extremely fast by using caching and async loading, so no more manual work and plugin compilations. A log file tracks plugins and versions, just like any other modern package manager. Here's my before Lazy init Lua, where I was requiring Packer and had the notion of use before every plugin. Since I started my current configuration with kickstart.nvim, this is what I had by default and it's pretty standard. By the way, I'm using another useful plugin called Twilight to help me highlighting the bits of code I'm currently working on. It's very useful in a cluttered code environment or just bouts of focus I occasionally need. But back to the configuration, you can also notice the way Packer works with more complex plugins configs. It is using a function surrounded by curly brackets. This is also going to be slightly changed when I move to Lazy, so let's see how that's done. First and foremost, quite obvious, changing Packer to Lazy as the global requirement, and the method changes from startup to setup. The method setup is somewhat different with Lazy, and it takes a list of objects rather than a bunch of commands like Packer does, so curly brackets are the sign for that. Now, basically every simple plugin entry that has the word use preceding will now change to just the plugin's name followed by a comma since it's an array. We can sprinkle some Vim magic here by running a regex that takes care of the indentation, eliminates everything but the plugin's name, and adding a trailing comma. Let's analyze that for a second to see how it really does that.
Let's analyze the regex used here because I think it's both cool and useful to know. So our goal here is to replace the line that says use and the plugin path to the same thing without the word use, and then we want to add a trailing comma. So by marking the line and running a Vim command, it provides the starting few characters, and that's showing us that we're operating on the selected area, rather than, for example, the entire document. Then I add S for a switch and open a slash. Slash will be my separator here. Then backslash V captures the vertical tab, which basically means all empty spaces that form the indentation until the word use, so I don't have to align everything to the left, it'll stay in place. Then the word use itself, followed by a space, and now the cool part. Wrapped in parentheses, we add dot star. That means all characters, and we capture them in the parentheses. Then we add another slash operator and backslash one. This is a way to reference the captured group, and then all that's left is to add a comma. Now the closing slash and GC. G stands for global. It's a global change over the entire selection, and by adding C, we get a confirmation box for every match so that we don't accidentally hit unwanted lines. Maybe we have the word use in one of the plugin's names or something like that. We want to confirm each and every target that is replaced. That's basically it.
I forgot to close my curly brackets for the array. This is probably driving the LSP mad, so let's quickly do that. I use percent to jump to the matching parentheses, adding the bracket and removing the word end, which previously was used for the startup function. Now, I'd like to run my regular expression on the inside of the code block. I'll do that by visually marking the insides, which leaves me at the end of the visual block. In visual mode, O takes me back to the other end, at the beginning of the marked section in this case. If you were paying close attention, I had GC at the end of the replacement command. G stands for global, either the code or the doc, and C is running on the entire section but asking for permission for every replacement. This is useful here since I don't want to replace the more complex configs just yet. We'll need something more tailor-made for them. Whenever you mention a tailor-made command in Vim, this is probably referring to macros. If you're unfamiliar with macros, please check out the video above. Knowing macros is like a superpower for Vim users. I'm recording a macro with QQ, the Q register that is. I'll delete the word use, the space after it, by deleting everything till the opening curly brace. Then I'm going to its matching pair and adding a comma. I'll stop recording the macro and go to the next use command. By the way, a smarter move here is to just search for the word use before I'm recording a macro and adding the command n for next at the end of the macro. And then after every run, it'll just automatically throw me to the next finding. That's very useful. A quick check health lazy can help you greatly if things go wrong, but be sure to run it for validation of the changes after you're done regardless. To run lazy, just run the lazy command and it starts the UI. You'll see a menu on the top with different options that lazy offers. So to start with, I'll just run I for installation of the packages. And if updates are available, lazy will let me know and then I could use the command u for a bulk update on everything. We'll do that in a sec. C is check and it's useful for checking for issues, breaking changes and so on. Now that I'm ready, I'll run the update command and see everything gets updated and even the hash from the git sha. P stands for profile and that may be the very reason you're here because it definitely is mine. Profile runs Neovim with the startup time flag internally and breaks down the loading times for each part. I'm pretty happy with mine considering I've just set it up, but I'm sure there's lots I can do to improve. If you keep digging into the profile, you can actually learn a lot just by going through the list of loaded plugins and modules and understanding whether there is something that slows you down in particular. This is also a great opportunity to either remove unused plugins or find modern, faster alternatives to the ones that you already have. I won't name names here, but there are definitely a few candidates in the list here to say goodbye to. After reviewing the list, I recommend checking out the debug section where loading times are broken even further. They keep a tab on average, max, min times, and total loading time overall. That covers lazy, but please, please, if you're making the change, let me know in the comments below whether you've seen a dramatic change, and of course, if you're tackling any issues trying to migrate from another setup. Go ahead and catch the next video right here, and I will see you on the next one.